following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tiger Technician Hour with your host, Basil Chapman. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, Basil Chapman.
Hi everyone, Basil Chapman live. This morning I did the show, I'd recorded the show thinking that I would not be available at 12 o'clock. A whole bunch of circumstances made it so that I'm actually here. And as the market has been coming down, excuse me, I thought this is really an important moment in the market, because the Dow had actually traveled all the way up to 26,330. It's now down at the 25,774 level, down 476. So this is really important. All the stuff that I was talking about earlier on the, in the recorded show this morning occurred in an hour. My thinking was that it would take until tomorrow. When I was doing yesterday's show, I had mentioned, in fact, I got an email from a couple of people. One in particular said, based on convincing me the market is going to revisit the mid to low 25,000 over the next 2 to 4 weeks, I moved half my money out into cash, awaiting another move to enter low. That was this last night. Your confidence seemed extremely high today on another M to H pattern formation coming soon. Thank you. And then I got an email this morning saying, wow, that was great timing, great call. Thank you. So that's not the point. The reason why I wanted to just mention that particular email is that, oops, I can't get this one either, is because I needed to be looking at a pattern that doesn't fail us very often. If it did fail us, today probably would have been the day that the Fed said something and the Dow would be up in the 26,450 or higher area. If that occurred, I would have had to say to you, you see this chart on the left, the Dow chart, down 469. You see this potential cup formation. You see that I drew in a pattern that said lowercase h can go to a lowercase m. And there's your first h, and it went to a lower low, unlike the S&P and the Qs. It did not break the left side low of 25,440. The left side low of the date of the 7th of August, when it went down to the low of the 15th, the Dow was the only one that did. I had to consider that in February of this year, to the April test of the lows, the Dow was the one that, was it this year or was it last year? Whatever it is, the Dow, let me just go to it right here, see what I'm talking about. Okay, there it is. So we came off. All right, now I can't remember what it was. It was a test. Oh, it was the low that was made in March. In March, the Dow made a lower low, in that, and the S&P didn't. Anyway, the whole point of this was that this lowercase h did go below the left side low of 25,440, went to 25,339, and then it ran up and it hit yesterday the 50-period exponential moving average right there with a high of 26,388. The MACD actually crossed positive, and if the MACD crosses positive after taking all the way from our high where we shorted the Dow 7 points off the top, on the 16th of July, 27,398, if it took all that time and then crossed positive, the Dow should have taken from the 25,339 low to the 15th, should have at least pushed higher above the 26,426 high that was made round about the 13th of August. And it couldn't do that. That made me worried. So yesterday I was saying, this is the pattern. And I believe it was yesterday that I drew in the rectangle formation to say, hey, just think that a rectangle formation, you can stay in this trading band a lot longer than your patience. And that's all. That was the most important thing. And the reason why I discussed the 200 period moving average in the daily, which is at 25,862, and why I said that the weekly chart uptrend line from the December low of 21,712, made the 26th of December, running all the way to 26,695 and then reversing from the April high down to 24,701 on the 3rd of June. That trend line has been broken three times in the last 3 weeks. And I had said if it closes under that, that is going to be an issue. But even more important in my work, the reason why, I know it felt a bit premature based on price, but I said I'm putting in a down arrow in the weekly chart and last week for my subscribers to my opening call, where every Saturday or at the latest Saturday night, maybe Sunday morning, I send out the charts for Monday, and I always show this big overview of the Dow daily, weekly, monthly. I'd said I'm going to a sell mode in the weekly chart for two reasons. One is, actually there were three reasons. This can only be a peak E. There is no other letter for it in the Chapman Wave methodology. Why? Because we had already gone down last week. For 2 weeks, in fact, we went under the 14-period moving average, the black line, and the MACD finally crossed negative in that M-shaped pattern that I call the camel double hump. You know, there's some camels that have two humps. This is like an M-shaped pattern. The second hump went negative. That's usually not a good thing, especially in a weekly chart. Number two, that was number two. And number three is that together with the MACD, it's like 3A and 3B. 3A is the MACD cross negative, and 3B is that the stochastic went from over 80% to under 80% altogether. So what do we have? We had Chapman Wave silent doji technique that I discussed at a webinar on this some time ago. If you subscribe to my webinar from Wednesday night, you will also get a whole bunch of webinars for free. Plus, you'll get my monthly newsletter for 30 days for free. And I think that was a very timely webinar that I did. So this silent doji on the week of the 26th of July with a slightly lower high of 27,368, whereas the week before it was 27,398, just 30 points off it, was a clue, especially with that big red candle, that this has to be considered a sell mode, sell signal, immediate upgrade to a sell mode in the weekly. Now, I have to also mention, this is descriptive. This is not a prognosis of future weakness to come in the sense that it's saying, oh my goodness, sell mode in the Chapman wave, that means you're going down even deeper. What it does say is that you've met all the criteria to designate it a sell mode. Other things tell you how long and how wide it'll be. One is where we close. It could still be a bounce. I mean, Trump had his tweet that came out this morning. First of all, it wasn't a very polite tweet to Chairman Powell, especially spelling it with one L instead of two. But what the L can you do about that? In the meantime, back at the ranch, he then sent out saying American companies need to start looking at alternative resources, not China. So under these conditions, the wider that the MACD space is, going into days close into the...
If you're not currently using the TAS profile scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS profile scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay Area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Hi everyone, Basil Chapman live right here at TFNN. The Dow is now down 406, S&P's down 48, 47. And it's coming back a little bit. You can see on the left there, automated Chapman wave support levels of 2870 to 2867. In the 5 minute chart, 2864 in the 2 minute chart. And the low so far is 2863.25. Trying to rebound here, 2880. He has a 10 minute E mini chart, made a peak E right there at 210 this morning at 2936.75. Went sideways for quite a while, hit the 200 period moving average, tried to rally, failed, and then plunged, and the low so far. So you've gone from 2936 to 2863, all in the space of a couple of hours. Just that's really something. Anything can happen, but I felt I really needed to go through a couple of things. I prefer to do it live since I'm here. If I wasn't, obviously, I couldn't do it, but I am here. So I just wanted to say, this is the reason why I'm saying, and I said it yesterday, I didn't see crash material at this particular time, but I did see sideways, and the real issue is going to be at some point, if there is a test of the 25,440 to the 25,330 area of the Dow, and there is a close below 25,200, we've got to be careful because there could be a lot more selling. But we could keep doing this, just really ruining it for the bulls, ruining it for the bears, as we, hour by hour, we just trade in this 1,000-point up, 1,000-point down range, maybe 2,000 is called it on the Dow, and just mess everybody up until there's a point where we have no more buyers, no more sellers, market can start fresh, have a decent move to the upside. I don't think we're ready, and that's what I was saying. So it's not, there's no pat on the back for anything, even though we are still short the Dow. We still have a short position from starting from 7 points off the top at 27,391. So we started buying the 200%. We bought the DOG and we have the DXD, which is now we've got a little bit left of the 200% short. Not a big deal. It's just that that was the position that said to me, we've got to consider that all the ingredients, and that's the reason why I was talking about it yesterday, I want to talk about it today. All the ingredients for a choppy market are there. There is no leadership. If we had a leadership, if the semiconductors were leading instead of being down 4 points right now at 110, still actually holding not badly, but instead of leading and being at 118 right now, being at 110, there is very little leadership. Even the XLK, which was holding very nicely, it's just not doing that great. So I'm just suggesting to you, it's a time to be very specific about what you want. We were very fortunate because overnight, one of our stocks that we have, there was a takeover, and that's Carbon Black being taken over by VMware. VMware is a stock, when it came out as an IPO, some of you might remember that we ran it up for at least 100 points. We actually were shorted it for about 100 points, and then it just kind of went off my radar. Not that I always didn't think it was a great company. I don't know why. We just didn't get into it. Sometimes I have to just move on. I don't know what it is. Akamai was the same thing. So anyway, I guess I've got a habit of just moving on. In the meantime, back at the ranch, what we are looking at here, just to make it real clear, I'm not sure that Trump can have a meeting now to kind of resolve something. It'll just be a temporary resolution. You can see that there are plans afoot. He's had plans afoot all the time. He has a kind of a visceral reaction to timing. It has to be done. And it's not how, where, or why, it just has to be done. And that's the way he gets, he's satisfied. There are certain things many of us have been talking about for not just a year, but for years about China. I mean, I told a story once about a friend of mine who had done business with the Russians, and he thought, man, if I could handle the Russians, I have to drink vodka like 10 times a day. Every meeting, every time you say, oh, get a swig of vodka. He said, if I could get business and successful, he was in the schmutter business, in retail clothes. And he said, I can do business with China. So he meets with his Chinese, whoever it was, and I love the story. So he meets with the person that set him up, and everything's going along fine. He thinks he's starting to do business with them. He gives them products and designs and everything. They're going to make it real cheap. And suddenly the orders, he doesn't kind of receive what he's wanting. So he quickly flies and surprises them. He flies over, he goes to the factory, and he's sitting in the office, and there's all sorts of piles of different things. And he's talking, this is a true story. And he's talking to the chairman or whoever it was that he was meeting with. And he's talking to them and he's saying, what's going on? And as he's sort of leaning over, and he rests his arm on this big pile or whatever it is, and he's talking, and he's waving his arms, and suddenly he looks down, and on his shirt, he sees this kind of design of something. He looks closer. There were his designs that they were manufacturing, but the material was being like Xeroxed, and he had some of it come up on his shirt. So, of course, he left very quickly. That was a long time ago, so they changed. They got better and better at doing all sorts of things, but there's no question, there's just no question that as far as the legitimacy of the copywriting, et cetera, there was nothing there. And you couldn't do business unless you had a Chinese partner. So you can understand that something had to be done. Should it have been as blatant as it is? Is it one of those cases where when the horse is out the barn, the politicians, as always, they're in the caboose in the train, and they can see exactly which way the wind is blowing, and the train stops at the station, and they know that they're going to look that way because that's the way the wind's blowing, and they say exactly the right thing. Is this too much too late? The absolute right thing, but it should have been done in the previous administration? I don't know. We'll find out. But all I can say is that these are things that had to be done. It's been kind of brutal. But it was brutal the other way around, just that nobody ever spoke about it in those terms. So, yep, he's a little boorish in what he does. We'll see what happens. I mean, this is serious stuff. So I wanted to just get onto the show. I wanted to say, please be a little careful here. If you think that there are great buys coming up, put your order in, but make it a little smaller, because I think there's so much uncertainty on the chart. And the reason why is, look at this trend line in the Dow. Look at the trend line that has just been broken twice. It was broken last week, but we closed just on this red dashed line. Now the day is young, but we are down 450 points. So we are well underneath this trend line. It would have to go to 26,050, to probably 26,100 to close above it. So I'm saying to you, please be careful. That monthly chart, remember, 9 months consolidation from January of 2018 to the high of October of 2018, 9 months, plummets down, comes right back. 9 months later, we make another high. That sequence says, be careful, we should be having a red candle for August. I'll be right back. Basil Chapman, Tiger Technicians Hour, live, not the recorded show I did earlier. This is the live show because we want to talk about the dollar. I'll be back.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawn charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found the computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com. The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, folks. We're back live at down 445 and speeds down 52. So you can see I'm talking about this lowercase h. It's a pattern that we always talk about called the dreaded h in the Chapman Wave methodology, going to a lowercase m. So it's stuck in this range regardless of what happens. It needs to hold next week, must hold the 25,300s on a closing basis. All right, I need quickly to go to gold because gold has had a spectacular move to the upside. It is still in the trading band that we set between 1546, gold set itself, between 1546, and didn't I type that in? 1488.9, let me just put that in here, 14. 1488.9. And this trading band says that if it starts to trade, and I said this yesterday, if for whatever reason gold starts to trade in the 1553 area, it should come right back into this trading band. But if it holds for 2 out of 3 sessions, something's going on. This currency of fear is getting some real traction. Didn't give us a chance. I wanted it for subscribers. We want to have a relook at the gold stocks on a pullback. Some of them pulled back very sharply. But this is a big move, and it's a scary move because it's saying that gold is in play. Silver is following. Gold is up 1.75. Silver is up a little more, 1.94. And I drawn in the smaller rectangle. It's out of that now. I didn't expect it to do that in one day. The reason why I wanted to do the show instead of just having the recorded one is that parameters on a daily basis right here have been changing over the last couple of hours, just so quickly. So if silver continuous contract is able to get close above 17.49, the high of the 13th, there's a chance that we might have to start counting this as an alternate count, and we'll see if it can go higher because it's pushing right up against the monthly, the weekly orange 200 period exponential moving average. That should be resistance. So the higher it goes away, it says the greater the chance that the elasticity of the 200 period moving average to become a magnet and then a propellant or repellent line is starting to get some kind of traction. And we'll see if that can happen. Otherwise, it's going to be stuck at 1738 for a little while. But leg B in the monthly chart, that's very good. Hey, wait a minute. Let's look at crude oil. Crude oil, look at that, smashed to the downside. It went underneath the rectangle support. It's early in the day. It could still turn around and go up. But so far, it has gone there. But that weekly chart, I said before, I had someone asking me, is this a time to be buying? And I said, I don't think so. I think that crude oil is, I don't see it terribly much higher, but I do see that it's going to do some downside testing. Boy, today is the test. So we want to look at bonds. Bonds should be screaming higher. They're up $1.88 in the TLT at $145.45. I had to still consider that this was in the U.S. This is the U.S. dollar. Same thing is up 1.9. Earlier when I did the pre-recorded show at 8 o'clock, it was down about 4.30 seconds. So at 165, 13, 30 seconds, it is kind of close to the high that was made at on the 15th of 166 and 30 seconds. So that says to me that the whole action of the TBT trying to rally has been thwarted. It's been thwarted because the market pushing down says that money, coming back to the dollar, money, the real issue is that money should have gone out of stocks and into bonds, kind of what it did in a little bit of a way, but then it should have come right back as money was flowing into stocks. Bonds should have pulled back much more, and they didn't. They've held quite well. So today's one of those days where you can see that the TLT is getting money in as the volatility of equities is making some investors nervous. That's kind of what you usually see. So we're going to be watching that closely. I said yesterday a close below 142 in the TLT would set in place a deeper correction. It hasn't happened. Now we're going to go to the currencies. Look at this. The dollar is down sharply. But if you look at the weekly chart, look at the number of red candles, and yet the strong ones on the green side have been much bigger. At this particular point, I've been saying for a little while that the rally that came from the 97.03 low of the 9th of August had every single day had a new slightly higher high. And yet it went to this peak A at 98.45 on the 20th, and then couldn't get through it. It used up all that energy with smallish candles instead of this huge move in a single leg that went to peak E on the 1st at 98.68. Look how long this took. And the MACD was okay, wasn't great. And the stochastic was good, but not great. It wasn't even over 80%, just 74%. And I say we've got to be a little careful. I even put in that circle right here to say we've crossed positive, but I don't want to see this MACD cross negative. Well, it's just done that. It just crossed negative. Now it leads to the reason why I wanted to do the show. I know the Trump had said, strong dollar, strong dollar. We don't need a strong dollar. We want lower rates and a weak dollar. And this move down 44 pips at 97.76 after intraday. And this morning, it's already at 98.45. Look, 98.45 is just 14 cents away from breaking to a new recovery high above the 98.68 high of the first. But the fact that we took time, and I drew this in for subscribers the other day, I drew this trend line to say, look at this, the Chapman wave inside track repellent zone. We need to close decisively above it. Otherwise, this is going to be a repellent. Well, it was a repellent today. We went above it, but now we're way below it. We're way below the 14-period moving average. We're about to test the 50-period moving average at 797.65. And the weekly chart has made a leg here, F/B, in the dollar that says, I want to see a trade at 98.51 that holds for one full day for us to be able to retest the 98.68. That's what this particular inverted candle means, downside candle. So there's a lot going on. And is this the time? I don't know what is Trump going to do to lower the dollar? I don't know anybody in the den have an idea? I'm not sure what he can do. I know that he can say things, and maybe that's what it is. But I still think, and this is going to be a very big clue for me, I'm trying to put a whole package together here. Remember, I did this yesterday. Cintas, look at that move down, almost 4.68 at 259. And just the other day, it was at 270.36. 270.36 is 36. And that was 8. I think it was a 20. I'm going to put 20. I can always change that. Now I'm in 20. What was that? I'm going to put 20. I'll change it if I'm wrong. And now it is down at the 259 area. And this is, just for now, I'm calling it leg F. I don't think it's F. I think it's going to be an alternate count, F/B. Meantime, the MACD is still good. Stochastics at 91%, still very strong. Relative strength has turned down, but still very strong in the weekly chart. And a potential doji candle. I'm just trying to put the package together, and what I am saying is that Cintas, overalls, uniforms, and rentals is on my list here, because if it starts to break, I'd say if it goes under 255 by next week, I'd be very nervous about that, because it could be mentioning some rotational recessions, not the overall market recession, but some areas, and we'd have to look at Marriott. Marriott is, look at Marriott. Ooh, I'll be back. We'll talk about this.
If you're in the CD market and looking for secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the tax opportunity zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly, paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a four-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal four-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the four-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you would like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
It's amazing to think that Tom O'Brien started his weekly gold report 17 years ago with the first issue published April 7th, 2002, when gold was trading at under $300 per ounce. Gold peaked at more than $1,900 in 2011, and after spending many years consolidating at lower prices, gold may be poised for its next big run. Tom O'Brien publishes his weekly gold report every Monday morning for subscribers, consisting of coverage of the XAU, HUI, GDX, the dollar, bonds, South Africa, African Rand, as well as 25 different mining equities with specific buy-sell recommendations. As of April 1st of this year, the Gold Report currently has 8 active positions with an average unrealized profit of almost 8% for each open trade. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. For all the details and to start your Gold Report subscription today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. Don't let gold's next big run pass you by. Sign up today. Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
I've always just had a question. Are you doing this live? Because I had done the recorded show earlier, because I didn't think I'd be able to do this show at noon. A bunch of factors came into play, and I am here, and I thought, oh, no. I'm going to do this now because I'm going to be able, let me have a drink of water here. I'm going to be away next week, and I just want you to do this. It'll also save me for subscribers a little bit of effort in going over more charts than I usually do. And even more important, I wanted to spend a good chunk of today and tonight getting things done for subscribers. I can start seeing the charts out because I actually am going to take a vacation. I am going to take it a little bit easy. And I thought I'd get them all done so I could have most of the weekend free. So I'll still get that done. So yes, I'm live. But I'm looking at Marriott. You see this double top of 149.21 on the January of 2008 peak D in the Chapman wave plunges down to a trough F. That was very seldom do you see monthly charts move down in all the way to a trough F and then have a V-shaped recovery. Usually it's like a C or maybe even a D, but all the way down to an F and then have a monster move back all the way from 149.21 high to the 144 high of last month. And now look at the red candle. And that's just saying to me, please be careful. That's the reason why I wanted to put Cintas, which is overalls and uniforms, just for like the hotel and the food industries, etc., pulling back here. Look at this H pattern. Someone asked me, hey, aren't these H's to M's all over the show? Look at this H right here, the dreaded H in the Chapman wave, a little H going to another H. That's like a big H, lowercase h. And now we're about to test the low of 124.77 of the 7th of August in Marriott Hotels, Marriott International Hotels, trading at 125.44 down 275. So I thought I'd just do that and look, the patterns that we're always looking for, arch or cup, straight line. Here's your arch. And it's about to do a test on the left side low. So it's doing that in the daily. It's doing that in the weekly. Hasn't even got close to doing it in the monthly because that would take it all the way down to 100. And so far, it's 25 points above that. And that's the reason why I'm saying, don't get too carried away thinking, oh, got a short. But just have a little caution here. You know, raising a little cash, it's fine. Don't forget, by the end of the day, there could be an announcement. You could be 200 points off the low. But I am saying that my sense has been for weeks that we're going to have the rally. And then you're going to make the H to an M pattern. And how you test the left side lows, I'll give it to you right now. The S&P, the left side low, because I do think we're going to chop to the downside, is 28.22. Start trading in the 28.18s over the next week. That's a problem. That really is a problem because you've broken some key support levels. I don't know if we're going down to, I don't think we're going down to the December low. That was a whole different set of issues that were involved there. But I do think that we're in for a very choppy period with lower highs and lower lows in many sectors. Look at the SMHs right now, the semiconductor. Look at that. There's your arch formation holding quite nicely, actually, when you consider that it's down, well, 3.38%, which is almost double the S&P. Oh, I already drew it in. There's your H pattern right there. Okay. 123 was the all-time high in July. And plummets down to the 107s. We were lucky, we were short and managed to take profits. But wait a minute, the big rally goes to a peak D. We had, Dan, was it? Who called me the other day? We were looking at this, was it Mike or Dan? And I said, yes, if you want to short, just put a stop. And I said, I think 115.25 or something. Did we hit that? No, 115.09, 115.14. So, I hope you are short, but that would have been the position because I said that was my leaning, but you really wanted to wait to the for the Fed to announce, and then if it was starting to go down, you could implement that trade. So, yeah, you got to be careful. And the monthly, the weekly chart only now is crossing negative in the MACD and flat, actually, not very deep. So there could be some strength coming in here in this rotational aspects. Just keep in mind, this is an opportunity where you've got favorite stocks. Do two things. Get a reasonable price that you'd like to enter and get an absolute crazy price that you wouldn't even dream that it could go down to. And maybe you'll get one, maybe you'll get both. Maybe you'll get one and get stopped out. And then the crazy one is the one that you land up with. We haven't had a flash crash in a long time, but we've had some crazy 1,000 pointers. So be prepared that anything can happen in this environment. That's really my big story right now. You don't have to follow the VIX or the. Just think of it this way. Had a spectacular move for the first 6 months of the year. You would anticipate, just based on even this candle here in the SMHs, that this candle needs a little more time to resolve that very big move to the upside. Just breathing like in a race. You just need to breathe sometimes. So I needed to do that. Michael in Toronto. Michael, how are you?
Yeah, hi.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good. Is this the Michael I hear from every once in a while?
Yeah.
Good.
I was wondering if you could take a look at the XOP.
Yes, certainly. This is the Spider S&P Oil and Gas Exploration. Now, I spent a little time on my show, in my webinar the other night, looking at the XLE. Now, they are sort of separate, but they tend to trend together. The XLE is down 1.32 at 56.68, and the XOP. Do you have a position?
I'm looking to get into this.
Okay.
I mean, it's really
so
beaten
up. I'm looking
up.
To get it.
Beaten up I'm looking and, to... like, basically, how low can it go?
There's never a how low can it go because when it was up at 80, 82 or 83, and it broke key support level at the 200-period moving average and made a dreaded H, you could have said, hey, man, this is so close. The magnet of the 200-period moving average should bring it back to the 40s. Oh, yeah? It went down to the 20s. So all I'm going to say to you is let's do a little Chapman wave notational aspect right now where we've got a little time. Yep. Let me just check the time for 1 second. Okay, so let me do this. We're A, peak B, peak C, peak D, and peak E, right to the 200-period moving average of the weekly chart, and now it is under the left-side low that was made back in January, I think it was, 2016, of 30.85. The January of 2016, 22.06. Today's low is 20.92. So... do you have a moment? Because we're about to go to the break. I'd like to do a little notational work, and then I can get right back to you on this.
Okay, I'll call back next week.
No,
okay.
No. Thank you very much. Can you hold on a few minutes?
Okay, sure.
Hello? Okay, hold on, because I'm going to be back. I didn't want the clock to run out and then just say to you, oh, and then rush an answer. What I am going to say to you is that I've already got the pattern in the monthly. Now let's look at the daily. So the daily hasn't taken out the left side low of 20.56 made on the 15th. It did run up all the way to 22.66. Today's low so far is 20.95. So I think I'm going to be able to give you some sense of support levels as soon as we get back. So hold on. Michael, I'll be back in a moment. I'm just going to check out the levels that I think are the supports to at least look at. I'll be right back, folks. That was done 400.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get the competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated fulvic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, folks. This is Steve Rhodes. Stay tuned for another great hour of the Trader's Edge heard here at TFNN.com.
So we're on with Mike in Toronto, and we're looking at the XOP trading at 20.95, down $1.01. The left side low is 20.56. The trend line support is down in the 19.50 area, and my Chapman Wave automated support levels have just been pierced. I don't like that. When you go through them, it means that you got to wait for the next ones to appear. So 21.13 is kind of the weekly one, and we're at 20.95. And the monthly ones, I don't have anything until much lower. At 20.88 is the next one on the 10-minute chart, and we are really close to that. Mike, I'm going to suggest that you wait to see how this arch formation tests the left side low. I don't think there's a rush to get in, because even if it does bounce, you will certainly have an opportunity to get it on a retest of the lows. So I'm just going to suggest to you, if you want to nibble as an experiment, just to see if you can get a feel for it, You could even maybe buy a call option, a 21 call option for September if it hits 20.50. And just say, you know what, let it tell me that way. It's just a very inexpensive way to do it. Maybe you can get it for $2.10 or $1.80, something like that. But I am going to suggest to you, you've got to wait because crude oil is breaking key support. The XLE, the energy sector, is breaking key support. I wouldn't be in a rush, but now I'm not going to be here next week. So if you want to email me at basilchapman@tfnn.com, just email me, mention that, you know, we spoke about the XOP, and I'll look at it during the week. But I would just give it a little time. Don't be in a rush. The way the monthly and weekly charts are looking at, even if it has a bounce, I think it's going to have to do some retesting. I hope that helps you.
Okay, thank you very much.
And thank you for calling. Always appreciate it. So, folks, let's just do this. Dow's down 477. I just wanted to give you a sense of what I'd be looking at next week in the Dow. Let's just do one at a time. I think we've got enough time for that. So let me do this very quickly. Upside resistance for all of them, upside resistance will be today's high. Just make it real simple. On the Dow, a close already under 25,800. A close below 25,600 says, watch out. We should be testing 25,440 to 25,339, the lows, most recent lows. A close below that next week is very bad. If it bounces, it could bounce and just continue. It could have another M formation. So, I've run out of time. Have a wonderful week. I'm on your way, but I